Chekhov 27, and it is finally the month of Christmas! That special time of year when a large man in a sexy outfit breaks into people's homes, raids their pantry, and watches their children sleep for a bit before laying out presents that have definitely been bugged by the Russian government. Wake up! Sheeple! Of course, I love this time of year as it's the only time I get to wear my sexy Santa outfit without being judged by the other moms at the daycare. But this is also a time for us to be giving. So to celebrate this month of cheer and home invasion, every video uploaded this month will be a suggested video. I will also be breaking into all of my subscribers' homes and watching them sleep. 'Tis the season, after all. So with all that said, let's get started. This video was suggested by Jace Guardian. Thank you, Jace. It's suggestions like this that make me hope that one day a meteor will strike the planet and kill us all. Barney's Hide and Seek game is a Sega Genesis title developed by Real Time Associates and was only published in North and South America. I presume that this is because Sega of Japan did not enjoy when the game came into its office soaked in its own cum and demanded that Hayao Nakayama not touch the controller because the game did not trust him to satisfy it correctly. I say this because the game quite literally plays itself. If you don't touch the controller, Barney has a little fit and then proceeds to walk to the end of the level. But I'm getting a little ahead of myself. Let's start over. Barney's Hide and Seek game is what happens when you let the neighborhood pedophile make a video game. But he's not one of those nasty pedophiles. He's the kind of pedophile that even the parents defend by saying, well, it's not his fault. You should have seen what little Timmy was wearing. But I'm pretty sure that this behavior only really applies to the Mormons. Wait, that's it! Barney's Hide and Seek game was developed by a group of friendly Mormon pedophiles. Damn, I am good at this. The game starts out with Barney dancing and throws up some instructions for the grown-ups, which just turned out to be an entire copy of Mein Kampf. Which is definitely an interesting way to start a game. After all that, you're dropped into the first level, a forest. The idea is that all of these children are hiding from Barney, so you have to find them so he can absorb them into his being to become stronger so that he can eventually take on the Teletubbies, who after moving their base of operations to the Middle East have rebranded themselves as the Talibani Tubbies. Alright, I was lying about the Barney bit, but the Teletubby thing is 100% true. Wake up! Sheeple. It's really just a game of hide and seek, which always ends with Barney hugging the children, always remembering to cop a feel while he can. But children aren't the only thing you're searching for. You're also looking for these presents, which hold toys, and while these toys look innocuous, do not be fooled. These rubber duckies are simply oddly shaped, child-friendly butt plugs. But enough about things that will get this video demonetized. Let's talk about the gameplay. This game is a 2D platformer. And I put that in quotes because while you do move left and right, there are platforms and Barney can jump, everything is as automated as it can be. You can't jump whenever you want. You have to wait for the game to allow you to jump. If you push the action button when the game doesn't want you to jump, Barney will blow kisses like an early 1920s flapper girl. You can't even walk off ledges in this game. Barney will always stop right at the edge because this game won't let me have anything. There's also a small amount of interactivity in the world. Barney can interact with certain animals and items by pouring cocaine over the top of them and just seeing what the fuck happens. This usually takes the effect that you would expect. Sprinkle cocaine on a sad bear. The bear gets happy, gives you a hug, then it's off to maul the nearest child. Then try to tell the child's corpse about the 30 internet business ideas he came up with in the last 20 seconds. And the entire time that Barney is wandering around, sprinkling cocaine on carrots, seductively blowing kisses at butterflies and inappropriately touching children, he does not blink once. This is the most horrifying thing that I have ever seen, and I've shared a bathroom with Jennifer Lawrence. Jennifer, why are there so many naked pictures of Mitch McConnell in there? But aside from Barney's cold, unfeeling eyes, that's pretty much all the game has to offer. Limited and insultingly hand-holding gameplay, packaged into four levels that are so forgettable that even while editing this video, I cannot, for the life of me, remember what they are. The game is also only around 20 minutes long at most, and that's if you meander and explore, which there is absolutely no reason to do because this game is just boring. Look, I understand that it was made for children, but come on. It feels like it's made for babies. Any child that can pick up a controller shouldn't be subjected to this much handholding. It's not fun when the game does everything for you. There is no possible sense of accomplishment in this game at all. Look, maybe I'm just being too tough, but I feel that any child who's willing and able to pick up a controller would be much better off playing something like Super Mario Brothers. At least then they have the ability to accomplish something. Children are not so brain dead that they need the game to play itself, then congratulate them on how excellent they were at sitting still and melting in a puddle of their own urine. Also, if all of this wasn't strange enough, this game has an active speedrunning community, which I'm sure only attracts the finest of bitches. Every time I go up to a girl at the bar, I just tell her that I've completed Barney's hide and seek game in 4 minutes and 20 seconds, which usually makes her orgasm a good 3 or 4 times on the spot.
Check off! It's time for dinner!
Shut up, Mom! I'm doing an in-depth comedic analysis on Barney's hide-and-seek game! It's hard to give this game a score, as it barely feels like a game at all. So I'll compare it to a game that I played around the same age that this game is shooting for. Let's explore the airport, which is a million times more creative and interesting than Barney's hide-and-seek game ever tried to be. Yes, there isn't any inherent challenge in the bulk of this game, but at least the game doesn't present itself as if there is. You quite literally just explore the airport, and it is fucking fantastic! And while there isn't any inherent challenge in the game, there are mini-games you can play that are a fine difficulty level for any child.
What is it?
Oh, what's that? That's an eagle. Fuck! That's an ostrich. Fuck! That's a chicken.
The answer is pigeon.
Bullshit! This at least makes it educational while at the same time being creatively interactive. Barney's hide and seek game isn't nearly as creative and lacks true interactivity. A child would actually get more out of a Barney episode than out of this game. And while it doesn't necessarily make me angry, I do feel the need to ensure that something like this never happens again. Hello, Miss Pig. I think it's time we took care of the purple dinosaur. You know what to do.
Hi, everybody. Oh, it's nice to see you.
Did you have fun on our make-believe mountain?
Oh, I certainly did. Enjoying the good fresh air and marching up to the tippity top.
And what did you see?
Well, the other side of the mountain was all that I could see. Oh, but there's a lot to see here.
I'm giving this game a 0 out of 5, and I'll see you all while you're sleeping.